remind you of? Does this give memories of childhood? Isn't it nostalgic?
किसने कहा कि नहीं आते वापस वो बचपन वाली बारिश? भूल गए हम शायद कागज के वो नाव बनाना।
Wow, are you trying to make us more nostalgic?
Well, yes, fam, I am. So let's go and find out more about this nostalgic product.
I guess half of the Godavari knows about our topic. So let's just proceed.
And we are not playing the guessing game here because they all know it. Paperboat, riding on the tide of nostalgia. So basically, riding on the tide of nostalgia. How this small company actually, on the basis of just one idea of the nostalgic emotion, created such a big brand, and we all know about it.
So our objective is to find out how a company can build a brand on just a feeling, nostalgia, and to know about the marketing strategies they used to inculcate in the Indian market.
So the contents, the flow that we'll be covering. PAPERBOAT is not an independent company. It comes under the umbrella of Hector Beverages. And Hector Beverages was established in 2009. There were four founders, Neeraj Biyani, Neeraj Kakkar, Subhas Misra, and James Nuttall. The headquarter is situated in Gurugram, New Delhi. And as you can see further, CEO of the PAPERBOAT is Neeraj Kakkar.
So PAPERBOAT is the only company which has brought Indian ethnic traditional beverages in Indian market. It started with Ampanna and Jaljeera.
And one more important thing, PAPERBOAT is not the first product which was launched by Hector Beverages. The first product was a protein shake, that's Frishia, and the other was an energy drink, Zynga. But unfortunately, both of them failed in the market of juice. So the targeted cities they covered are Mumbai, Pune, New Delhi, Hyderabad, Chennai, and Bangalore.
The investors are Catamaran Ventures, who initially invested 6 crores, followed by Footprints Ventures, Sofina Capital, and A91 is the recent investor, who they invested 300 crores.
So can anyone tell me who is N.R. Narayan Murthy? Anybody from the audience? Please raise your hand. You'll get a reward too. Just raise your hand. Yes? Exactly.
Smart,
so you'll get
audience.
A reward.
Okay. We have a very smart audience.
Yeah. So coming to the products, so PAPERBOAT is categorized into beverages as well as snacks. So under the beverages, there is a category for fruit drinks and as well as milkshake, which is the newest addition. And talking about snacks, they have kept that ethnic essence in their mind, and the same thing they have put into the snacks category. So you can see aam papad from our childhood, peanut chikki, bhakarwari, shakarpara, gurpara, etc. Well, this is just a glimpse of all the drinks that they have launched.
Let's move on to revenue. Fiscal year 16 had a revenue of 62 with a loss of 84 crores. And we can see that the loss in purple is decreasing, whereas the revenue is increasing over years. In from 17 to 18, there was a 71% rise in the revenues, which is 118 crores.
So the major competitors of PAPERBOAT are Real, Tropicana, and B Naturals. So as you can see, the three competitors belongs to a bigger industry, the Dabur, PepsiCo, and ITC. And variants, as you can see, PAPERBOAT got the most variant as compared to those bigger brands.
Strategies adopted.
So ethnic flavors, as I have told you earlier, that they always kept in mind the Indianness, and they have launched all the flavors regarding based on those ethnic flavors.
Hedonic value for its consumers. Hedonic means pleasant. So they have, the brand has established a product which a consumer can have an attachment. So they have developed an emotional attachment which has helped them increase their brand loyalty.
And The campaign that they have launched in social media was they told their consumer to upload some of the childhood memories and some happy moments so that they can relate to it and relive their childhood, which was a good strategy, by the way.
Unique packaging. So we know how, Paul, can you show them the package?
Yeah, definitely.
So they have a very unique packaging style. We can, anyone can, when it goes to a store, can distinguish PAPERBOAT from its competitors.
The proprietary customer feedback analytics. So what they did, they kept in mind all the different cultures of our country. So for example, the South Indian flavor. So the South Indians are very much prone to getting curry leaves and spices in their curries and vegetables. So what they did, there was a panakkam flavor, which was specially for Ram Navami. So just like that, they have launched some of the special occasional related drinks. So panakkam was one of that. It is just a mix of water and jaggery. The second was Eid. For Eid, they have specially launched Sharbat-e-Khas. And the third, so this time for second reward. Can anyone tell me, just raise your hand, the special drink that we get served on Holi?
Okay, who says Tandai?
Who says Tandai? Okay, so Vartika was the one, I heard her voice. So you and he will be getting a reward later on. That's the PAPERBOAT.
100% refund policy to the retailers. This is something very unique about the brand. They gave the policy to retailers when they initially came into the market that you can get 100% refund if no product has been sold.
Time for a short video.
So before that, who is the brand ambassador of PAPERBOAT?
Anybody?
Yes, Mandeep.
Nobody. Yeah, he's right.
Actually, memories are the brand ambassador.
Start.
कागज की कश्ती में सैर कर आया मैं बचपन में जाके खुद से मिलाया
आमरस from PAPERBOAT drinks and memories.
I'm homesick.
So her parents are living in Kuwait, so you can understand how homesick she feels.
Recommendations. We feel that maintaining the quality over years is very important. Many companies forget about it, about the quality of the product. That's why we suggest PAPERBOAT to have a maintenance of the quality over years.
And yes, as we youth are prone to get bored soon. So they should keep in mind about the youth that there are the changes that they need coming years, like flavors. They should not be constant in the flavors that they are launching and producing. They should go for some new and some exciting flavors too. And yes, brand ambassador. We believe that, just like any other bigger brand, brand ambassador plays a very vital role in advertising a product. So they should go further and start investing more on the brand advertising using a brand ambassador. Okay, before that, I hope that everybody heard the music of the video pretty well. So just raise your hand. Can anybody tell me from where the inspiration of the background music they got? Okay, the guy.
Amazing.
Good. So there are three rewards here. So coming to the conclusion, Femida.
They have targeted the Indian consumer needs. Like, we all got fresh juices. But who thought about amras, ampana, jaljeera? So they have actually targeted the Indian needs.
And the most important thing that most of the brands forget to get the attention of the customer using their emotions. And PAPERBOAT successfully did that. They kept the customer-centric approach always in mind. And yes, unique packaging, as you can see, it is easily portable and it comes in a pouch, which is better, you can say, eco-friendly than comparing the other products like Coca-Cola, Pepsi, as they come in plastics and tin cans.
We can conclude that not only on nostalgia, but along with nostalgia, they have built their brand PAPERBOAT.
Thank you.
Thank you.